So, module 7. So, we have been studying various topologies like induced topology, especially compactly generated topology, and so on. And one of the important thing in studying function spaces is the exponential correspondence on the function spaces. Basically, these things were done in part one very elaborately. Nevertheless, because of the importance of this part, I will recall them as much as needed for our immediate purpose here. So, first, let us recall what is the meaning of this compact open topology on the function spaces. Given two topological spaces X and Y, we denote Y power X, the space of all maps from X to Y. Maps means continuous functions from X to Y. Okay, this is given the compact open topology, which has a subbase corresponding to each compact set K and an open subset U. K is inside X and U is inside Y. You define a subset K, comma U, put them in brackets, okay, and take all of them. So what is this K, comma U? That is all continuous functions from X to Y, which takes F, this case, this K inside U. So F is from X to Y. F of K must be going inside U. Then you put it inside this KU. Take all such KU, okay, they are subsets of Y power X. They will form a subbase. Okay. So KU is all function F from X to Y, such that F of K is contained inside U. This one subbase means what? An open set, a set is open if and only if it contains, okay, it is a union of arbitrary union of arbitrary not finite intersections of K and U. So K1, U1, K2, U2, KN, UN, you take the intersection. That will be an open set. Okay. So arbitrary union of those things will be also open set. So if you take only finite intersections like that, will be form a base. So that is the topology. Okay. Then there is an obvious map E from Y power X cross X to Y given by E of F comma X going to Fx. If you fix X, F going to Fx is nothing but coordinate projection. I would not like to call it that way because now we are not thinking of Y power X as a product space, Y taken X times. There is also that topology. Whereas now we are concentrating on compact open topology. So if you fix X, Y X going to F going to Fx is obviously continuous even in the product topology. But what is important is as a joint function, this capital E from Y power X cross X to Y is a continuous function, is what we want to have. Okay, that is the first part of the theorem here. This E is precisely called evaluation map. Okay, what is the hypothesis on X? X is locally compact orthogonal. Y and Z could be any topology. Then the first part here is that E is continuous. The second part is really the name exponential correspondence. A function from z to y power x, where z is any topological space. Z to y power x is continuous if and only if the E composite G cross identity from z cross x to z cross y power x and then E. So z cross x to z cross y, that is continuous. Notice that G is continuous, then G cross identity will be continuous. If E is continuous, then the composite is continuous. The point here is on the converse here, namely if the composite continuous, why G should be continuous? In general, it may not be. So the theorem says that it is continuous under this hypothesis, namely X is locally compact and Hausdorff. The proofs are not very difficult. Nevertheless, let us go through that so that you will become familiar with the concepts of this compact open topology and the space y power x and so on. The first part is to show that E is continuous. You start with an open subset U inside Y, and you want to show that E inverse of U is open in the product space y power x cross x. So take a point f naught x naught in E inverse of U. What is the meaning of that? Then f naught is a continuous function from x to y. F naught of x naught is E of f naught x naught, that is inside U. But now U is open and f naught is continuous means for some neighborhood of x naught is taken inside U by f naught. But now X is locally compact Hausdorff space, so we can actually take an open subset V such that X is inside V, contained inside V bar, contained f naught of f naught inverse of U, and V bar is compact. So inside every open subset you can find a compact neighborhood is the local compactness part here. Okay. So what is the meaning of this? This means that now f naught of V bar is contained inside U, which is same thing as saying f naught is in the bracket V bar U. V bar is compact, U is open. So this is actually one of the subbases. So it is an open set. Since V bar U is an open set in Y power X, we get an open set V bar U cross V in the product, which will be a neighborhood of f naught x naught. Now you look at E of V bar U cross V. Okay, take a f here, take a point here, say any point, then f of that x must be inside U. Why? Because if it is inside V, it will be inside V bar. And f of v bar goes inside U. So therefore, E of f comma x will be inside U. So this proves that E is continuous. So that is part A. All right. Let us go to part B. Part B, there are two ways. One way I already told you. If G is continuous, G cross identity continuous, the composite will be continuous because we have just proved that E is continuous. So now let us prove the converse. Okay. Now I am assuming that this composite is continuous, then I want to show that G is continuous. For this, it is enough to show that the G inverse of all these sub-basic open sets is open, where K is compact and U is open. Okay. Take only sub-basic open sets. Inverse image of those things are open will mean G is continuous. Okay. So let Z naught belonging to Z. Z was arbitrary space, you remember. So that G of Z naught belongs to KU. That is the meaning of Z naught is in the G inverse of that. Then for every point K in K, what we have is E composite G cross identity of Z naught K, which goes to G of Z naught comma K, which goes to G of Z naught operating upon K. That will be inside. That is the meaning of this G of this is contained inside you. Okay. So there exists open sets VK, WK of Z and X respectively, such that this Z naught is inside VK, little k is inside WK, and E of all this WK, VK cross WK is contained inside you. So this is the continuity of this composite function E composite G cross identity. Okay. Now K is compact, so we can pass on to a finite cover. K is contained I range to 1 to n, VKI. Each WK covers little k. When you range k in k, that will be an open cover for k. K is compact, so I extract a finite subcover. We call that as W. And correspondingly, I take VK i's here. Okay, K1, K2, K i's are some points of capital K. Okay, there are finitely many of them. So I take V equal to intersection of VK i's. Then you put intersection here, the union here. E of G cross W, G cross identity of X of V cross W is contained inside. Okay, that just means that G of V is contained inside K cross U. Okay, K comma U, this notation K, inner product KU. Since V is a neighborhood of Z naught, we are through. So I have formed a neighborhood V here that goes inside that. So KU, G inverse of KU is open. So that proves this exponential correspondence theorem. Okay. Now we come to the study of the compact generator topology. Okay, the basic problem here is that if X and Y are compactly generated, in general, the product topology need not be compactly generated. Therefore, we are looking at situations where this may be true. That means you put extra conditions on X and Y under which this may be true. However, there is no if and only if conditions. Okay. So we will have to study whatever, you know, best we know about various conditions. Okay. So first lemma is, if Y is locally compact and X is compactly generated, okay, whenever I say this compact, all the time I assume Hausdorffness, of course. Both of them are Hausdorff spaces. Then X cross Y is compactly generated. If and only if, I want to conclude here, but this is a lemma, it's a part of this one. So if and only if every compact subset K of X, K cross I is compactly generated. Instead of saying the whole space is compactly generated, first you assure that K cross I, K cross Y is compactly generated. If you do this one for every compact set, then this will be fine. This is the lemma. Okay. So for this lemma also, I am already taking assumption that second factor here is locally compact. Okay. So already we are trying to see that if I just assume compactly generated, compactly generated, both of them, I don't get X cross Y compactly generated. So I have to make little more and more general situations here. So this lemma says that Y is locally compact. Okay, that is the extra hypothesis. Remember, locally compact outer spaces are compactly generated. So this is stronger condition than being just compactly generated. Okay, so proof of this one, you can try to do it point wise, going here, going there and so on. But exponential correspondence helps you in proving this one very elegantly. Okay, consider this function x going to x cross y power y with the weak topology, whatever, you know, product with the weak topology out there. Remember that. So take any space, whatever topology you have, then give the compactly generated topology. That is the meaning of whenever you have a topological space here, writing a suffix w. Okay. The set theory function eta from x cross y to y doesn't need all these things. It is just like the evaluation eta xy equal to xy. Okay. Remember, eta is what? Eta is function from, for each x, it's a function from y to x cross y. So I can evaluate it on y. Okay. So what I have, tell me what is the value? Value is xy. So this is a definition of eta. Okay, take this function. Okay, give me this one. Now look at the evaluation function, x cross y power y cross y to x cross y. This is the base space here. This is just like instead of x cross y, y, I have to have one more y here. Okay, so this is the evaluation map, E of, take a function here, take a point here. Okay, evaluate it at that point, you get a function point here. Because evaluation map, we have seen that, okay, if y is locally compact of our space, then this evaluation map is continuous. Okay, now look at E composite, take identity, this eta cross identity of y, operating by xy. Okay. This is eta of capital E of eta x comma y by definition. This is identity cross identity. Eta cross identity means that. But eta is evaluation. You have to evaluate E x on y. So that's x y. We now use the theorem on exponential correspondence in both directions. Once you have established this one. Okay, in between, we also use the hypothesis x is compactly generated and y is locally compact. So this much we have to use. Okay. So we get x cross y is compactly generated. This is the statement that we want to understand, that it's equivalent to something else. If and only if the identity map from x cross y to x cross y, this is compact generated. It's continuous. Okay, and remember, start with a space like this. When you make it compactly generated topology, that will be always finer than this map. So identity map this way is always continuous. If x cross y is compactly generated already, then you don't get anything more. So x cross y to this one is continuous. This is same thing as x cross y compactly generated. Okay, so first part is just by definition itself it follows. Second part is now, eta from x cross y power y to w is continuous. So this is the exponential correspondence now. Why? What is the map here? Identity maps. X comma y going to x comma y. What is the corresponding map in the exponential? It is the eta. Right? So eta of xy is xy. So if you look at that, this eta is continuous. Remember, then this is continuous. So that is the correspondence. Eta is continuous. Okay, this is exponential correspondence situated here. But now this is the same thing as saying for every compact subset K of X, the restriction map eta on K, restricted eta, let's call it eta K, from K to X cross Y W is continuous. Okay, this is a definition of the compact compactly generatedness of this part. Okay, so I have from K from arbitrary X, I have come to compact subsets now. Okay, so that was my idea, to come to compact subsets. Now you go back by exponential correspondence. So this is true for every compact subset. Okay, so, but that is depend on leaf. Now I go back, K cross Y to X cross Y, W is continuous. So this exponent Y comes here, K cross Y is continuous. Okay, by the exponential correspondence. But it, this is different on leaf, is for every K should be true. If and only if K cross Y, remember, Y is locally compact vector space. Okay, compact subset of K. So this inclusion map eta, this one is continuous. Okay, K cross Y, eta K is continuous here. If and only if K cross Y to X cross Y is continuous. But that is if and only if for every compact subset K, the inclusion K cross Y to K cross YW, because this inclusion, where does it go? I have taken the larger space, but it goes inside a K cross YW to continuous. If this continues from here to here, that will be continuous because they have the same weak topology here. Okay. So for this is true for every compact subset, which means that K cross Y is compactly generated. That is why we started with X cross Y to X cross W in the beginning. Now we have come to the same conclusion with X replaced by K. So this is the lemma here. Okay. So this lemma is proved now. What is the lemma? This lemma. So now we keep using it very beneficially to prove all this ABC. They are all different statements, but somewhat similar. X and Y are Hausdorff spaces. X cross Y will be compactly generated under these conditions. Easy to remember, first condition is both X and Y are compact, no problem. The product itself is compact, right? In a compact space, if you give compactly generated topology, it will be the same topology. The first part doesn't need anybody's, any lemma or anything. X is compactly generated and Y is compact. Okay, this is the first thing that we would like to prove. And then generalize this to X is compactly generated, but now instead of Y compact, Y is locally compact. So first part is obvious, the second is also obvious, but that will be needed to prove the part C, and this is our aim. Remember, in the lemma, we had this statement, if and only if something happens. So we will prove that statement to prove part C here. That is the whole idea. Okay. So let us go through it again. Since X and Y are compact, so it's X cross Y. For any compact space, compactly generated topology coincides with the given topology. That is part A. B follows from lemma and A. See, you want to show that X is compactly generated and Y is compact. Okay. Then what you have to do in the lemma, if and only if you take subspaces here, K compact subset, K cross Y is compactly generated. But K is compact, Y is compact, by A it will be compactly generated. It is true for every compact subset of X. Then this will be compactly generated, product will be compactly generated, is the lemma. So lemma gives you immediately B. Okay. Now use this one and again the lemma. Now X and Y role will be interchanged to show that X cross Y is compactly generated. Okay, this time by taking subsets, arbitrary subsets K of Y. Okay, that is what we are doing. Every locally compact Hausdorff is compactly generated. Therefore, C follows from B and the lemma. So, you interchange the role of where you take the compact subsets. That's all. So somewhat tricky, but the way the exponential correspondence helps is very elegant. So we have come to a stage where now we can study the topology of CW complexes, namely when you take the product complexes, X and Y are CW complexes. There is a canonical way of getting a product on CW structure on X cross Y. The only problem is the topology on X cross Y, namely the product topology, will be in general different from this CW topology. Okay, so that is the point we want to study. We will do it next time. Thank you.